Okay, so we are getting ready to board the plane. We're taking the PC-12 with Yajasi to Danawage. It's about a 50-minute flight. So we'll see you on the ground. Look forward to serving the people.
For 10 years, Paul Snider has worked as a missionary among the Northern Korowai people in Papua, Indonesia. Because the Northern Korowai only have a spoken language, Paul spent 8 years inventing a written form of the Northern Korowai dialect in order for the Word of God to be distributed and read for the first time in Korowai history.
Good to see you.
Yeah, you too. Wow. You too.
How long have you been gone?
2 years. It's
really?
Been 2 years now.
Wow.
Trying to heal up in the States.
Living in the savage jungle for years had taken its toll when Paul was struck by several mosquito-borne diseases. In addition to contracting malaria 3 times, Paul suffered dengue fever and chikungunya fever, which caused Guillain-Barré syndrome, which damaged his brain and paralyzed his body. But none of this stopped Paul from his work. By the grace of God, and while undergoing therapy to recover, Paul worked continuously on the Indonesian Bible Project, on book translations, reworking the orthography of the Northern Korowai dialect, and also recording theological materials in translation.
We've got food for a week. We've got some especially excited about some of the materials that Matt and I bought in Bandung. We're taking a lot of theological books in for the evangelist so that they can read good solid theological material. And then we're also going to be having a seminar this week going through the scriptures with them. So excited about taking all this stuff in because most of it's for them.
What would you say to someone who's like, after all that, why do you want to go back to the jungle?
My first response would be because Jesus is worth it and the gospel is more important than my health. Because he's really called us to suffer. I mean, suffering is not something we look at as a negative thing. It draws us closer to him and it sanctifies us. He uses that. Jesus is ever nearer in the suffering.
Northern Korowai are a tribal people who live in the lowlands of Papua, Indonesia. Their culture is entrenched in pagan practices and satanic rituals, their history darkened by cannibalism and murder, their minds enslaved to animistic beliefs. But in 2014, a group of Korowai men, including one man named Salomo, came visiting from a neighboring village. The men said to Paul, "We have come to learn God's word." That very day, Paul began to teach Salomo and the other men salvation history and also how to bring the message of the gospel to other villages. From this point, these men began taking the word of God to teach others. Paul hopes that through discipleship and by the grace of God, these men will be the first indigenous pastors of the Northern Korowai people.
Amen. Matt, do you remember Solomon and Young, believers from Waena? So these are the ones we taught for years.
It feels surreal to be back in my own home in Danawake after almost 2.5 years in the States, recovering. And God has been so kind to allow me to come back. I do miss my wife and children being here, though. It's kind of sad being in a home without them. But the Lord is so kind to allow me to come back and minister to the believers here and continue the work of translation with the Korowai. So we're going to have a good week here in Danawake with Matt. So this is the Salvation History Catechisms in the Northern Korowai language, and I also put the Indonesian language with it. So on the left is the Korowai language, the Northern Korowai dialect, and on the right is the Indonesian language so that they can learn side by side, because in the future I want to do literacy, plus the evangelists can learn the Korowai language while they read the Indonesian language. And this is going to be used in the church, in the schools, throughout the villages here in the north. Pretty much 99% of the tribe here cannot read their own language yet, since it's new. Wahyu is learning how to do it, so Wahyu and I spent years translating this together. And so this is really for him. He was just huge in this project, and so I'm thankful to God for Wahyu. But it's finally in our hands, both languages, and now we can pass it out this week.
Yeah, ini buku kecil bernama Injil Yesus Kristus. So this is a small book on the gospel that was written by Paul Washer. And we translated it last year and printed it with Lembaga Literatur Baptist in Bandung. We're going to try to distribute it here in the Korowai region to some of the evangelists so that they would have a better understanding of the gospel.
I have 300 of these. We've already passed out 300 2 years ago. I have 300 solar speakers with our translation of the Northern Korowai Catechisms. It's going to be uploaded today, and tomorrow we're going to take the helicopter to all the northern villages, and we're going to pass these out. And so this is something simple that they can charge under the sun, and they can listen to their own language and learn about God, how God worked through salvation history. Wahyu and I spent, 6 years translating and going. I was learning the language, I was going through the language with him. And so him and I sat at this table and some other tables in the house for 6 years translating this Salvation History Catechism project. I'm thankful to God for Wahyu because not only did I learn the language, but I could tell that his heart, he wants this to be passed out to his own people because he wants them to understand how God worked in salvation history and the culmination of Jesus Christ, that he is the Savior and of those that repent and believe in him alone. They can listen to it together as a family in their tree houses and in their homes. And they've also got the book. Once at least the young people can read it, the older ones definitely are going to use this in their home because all the adults can't read. Only those that have gone to school from kindergarten up to some of the younger adults now can read. So they're going to complement that with this book here that has the Northern Korowai language and the Indonesian language together.
I'm sitting here with Ibu Perin. Ibu is the wife of HeartCry missionary Jimmy, and HeartCry has partnered with Jimmy and Perin now for several years. They are both working with the children that you can see sitting here, and Jimmy is also the pastor here in Donawage. And so we're just going to give a short interview with Perin. I'm going to ask her a few questions, and then I'll translate it. Jadi Mama Perin, kami ingin tahu pada awal, Ibu berasal dari mana dan
untuk apa melayani masyarakat Korowai di sini.
Yeah. So she said that she comes from the area of Tolikara, and she just gives thanks to God that she was able to come here to serve the Korowai. Mama Perin, boleh kasih tahu orang
merubah semua anak-anak luar biasa Tuhan bekerja dalam pelayanan ini.
Mm-hmm. And so she says that she gives thanks to the Lord. She and herself doesn't have the strength to serve these children, but God has given her the strength. And so really she is serving these children from day to day. She is, we call her here Mama Perin. And so she's like a mother to all of these children. And so she said it's the Lord who gives her the strength, and they have seen much change in the lives of these little children who are here. Jadi Mama Perin ada kesaksian tertentu
yang jalan keluar ada Tuhan ada jadi.
Yeah.
Saya senang.
Yeah, I mean. Yeah, so she said that there are many challenges working with these children, but they try to walk closely with God in prayer, and they have seen God answer prayer and work in the lives of these children in spite of all of the challenges that they face. Jadi, Ibu bagaimana untuk
ya kasih dorong semangatkan saya sampai sekarang ini. Jadi, saya ke depannya.
Okay. Yeah. So she said that that oftentimes that she wants to give up, she feels sick, she feels tired, but she prays to the Lord and the Lord gives her strength. And then she prays and she asks God to provide more workers to come here to work with these children as well. She's been sick often, and she said that people tell her that she just needs to come out from the village and go out to the coast. But she feels that this is a calling from the Lord, and she can't just neglect the calling that she's been given. And so just pray for her. Pray that God would give her strength and heal her, and that she would be able to carry on the ministry that God has given her, the calling God has given her to evangelize these children and to teach them.
Yesus sayang semua, semua, semua. Yesus sayang semua, sayang semua. Sayang Bapa, sayang Mama, sayang Kakak, sayang Adik, sayang kamu dan saya, sayang semua.
Dadah.
Dadah.
This program is called the Saber Utility Program, so I can just go to attach all, and then it automatically copies our translation into the solar speaker. And it usually takes about 2 minutes average per two. So I'm sitting here probably for at least 4 or 5 hours until we get all 300 uploaded.
Okay, these are some books that we bought while we were in Bandung. We wanted to come here not empty-handed, but we wanted to come and to give the pastors and evangelists who are working here in this area some good books, some good literature.
Okay, so still uploading the speakers. It's about 9:30 at night, and we're taking the heli to 5 different villages in the morning, so I've had to upload 300 speakers today, and still going at it strong. Sitting here sweating, but I should be able to get them all done tonight, and we'll wait for the heli to come in the morning, and then we'll be able to pass out the translation.
Before tomorrow's delivery, Paul must load all of the devices with the audio recordings of Salvation History, but the cables connecting to the solar panels, which are his only power source, have been chewed through by rats. With the power out and only 4% of battery remaining on his computer, Paul races to finish loading the audio devices before the next day's deadline.
We're taking the helicopter because usually from my village to these surrounding villages, it's by helicopter, it's 10 to 15 minutes at the max. But if we were to hike by foot, it would take us between 6 to 12 hours to some of these villages. So we can go to a few posts within before lunchtime versus only probably could do just one within a couple days. So praise the Lord for the Heli Vita. They do great work. Yeah, so he was relating how what God has done in the church. There's a church planted now. In fact, we just finished about a year ago building a new worship building because the old one was falling apart. But more importantly, we've seen several come to know the Lord in Mabawage through Yusa's leadership there, opening the scriptures with him faithfully. And now we have a young man also named Ronnie that is seeking to further his Bible education because he wants to go back and minister with youth in the village of Mabawage. A lot of people have been attending the services regularly, he said, and have been faithful to come to hear the teaching of God's Word. And we're just very thankful. He's thankful as well, again, for the partnership with HeartCry Missionary Society. Okay. So Witinu said that his once his wife died, he didn't want to leave his post, especially since he was one of the leaders in the church here in Denawage. In fact, he still is one of the church leaders here, and in doing a fantastic job of
of discipling the congregation here and a lot of the children. He's become such a father to a lot of these children, and they love him dearly. He's just related to me also that he's seen the congregation grow spiritually, especially the children. Now, because there's a school, they've been focusing on a lot of teaching through the Bible, having Sunday school classes, having evening Bible studies, and of course on Sunday services. So he stays pretty busy, not only trying to live and take care of himself here, because this is a hard life. I mean, it takes three times as long to do everything for yourself. But he's done a fantastic job. He's a very faithful man. And he just relayed to me also that he wants to thank everybody in the States for his prayers and for all the help that they've given.
Well, we just finished the first day of our seminar here in Danawage, and we're teaching on things that are related in some way to the church, the nature of the church, Christ as the head of the church, things like that. And so we had a couple of sessions this morning. It seems that they've received well the teaching that's been given to them today. And so after the teaching, we spent some time and we passed out some books to them.
We just finished our second day of the seminar here in Danawage. Matt and I took him through the scriptures about what it means to lead the church, and we took him through 1 Timothy 3, Titus 1, and Matt went through several scriptures through the Old Testament as well of how of what it means to actually lead God's people, His sheep, faithfully according to scripture. And they were just relating to us how blessed they are by the word, because they even confess that they've actually become cold in some sense with the difficulties here of life, and that they've not been faithful as they should be. So praise God that He's using the Word to speak to their hearts and to change them. Well, good morning. I'm standing here in Danawage, and it's about 6 a.m. in the morning, and I just wanted to let everyone know that the solar speaker project is finished. So praise God. I mean, 600 speakers through your giving are now in the hands of Korowai people. And so what's going to happen now is we've even noticed they're walking around listening to them all day as they hike through the jungle, as they're walking through the village, as they're working, as they're sitting in their homes. You hear the speakers going on, and this will help them understand God's redemptive plan through history. I'm so thankful for how God has used these speakers, not only just the speakers, but now we have it in written form. So God is so good to give us all these tools for the people, and you can see His blessings to them year after year. So we're very thankful, and thank you for giving toward this project, for praying for it all these years, and seeing what God will do in the future for the Korowai. When you take the gospel into a place like this that's very remote, it changes everything. No longer do we see people running around arguing and carrying their bows and arrows and pointing them at each other. No longer do we see people raising their machetes. These things have lessened over the years. Now we see fathers carrying their children. Now we see fathers walking with their wives. The gospel changes everything. These aren't the efforts of Paul Snider. These are the efforts of the Lord Jesus Christ and His Spirit working among the people. Continue to pray for the Northern Korowai region as we continue to do many other efforts throughout the years, and continue to pray for the people that they would be faithful to the scriptures.